Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see how this all plays out, and a lot of people are interested to see as well. You can see many signs behind us, a number of people lining up to speak, people on both sides of this conversation, but many of these signs, as you can see, are red, saying tax Amazon fund housing and services. Those signs are from council member Shama Sawant's fans, and council members joining us right now. There was a late night proposal by Mayor Jenny Durkin and four other council members who opposed the original plan here. What's going to happen today?
Well, as you can see, they're not my fans, but they are people, working people, young people who are struggling to have a foothold in this city. We know the statistics are dire. Yesterday, we heard from a study sponsored by the Chamber of Commerce, no less, that King County urgently needs $410 million to fund immediately the building of 14,000 affordable housing units. And this is the response from Mayor Durkin to dramatically weaken the legislation that is in front of the council. I think it's important to keep in mind that Amazon alone gave Jenny Durkin's campaign $350,000 last year. You know, this is quite a return on investment for Jeff Bezos. But we should remember that whatever we win will be on the strength of this movement of ordinary working people who are setting their personal lives aside to fight for some sort of housing justice. So whatever we win will be on the strength of the movement. And I really challenge all the council members to stand with working people, not with Amazon.
We have, as we've seen, about five council members who support this. You would need six to override a veto by Mayor Jenny Durkin. To me, it seems you may need to compromise or you may get nothing at all. Do you see it that way?
You know, in reality, just the fact that we have to live in this brutal inequality-based society is a compromise. So I really think that this is a moment for council members to challenge themselves. Do we have the courage to actually put forward a proposal that is in line with what our working people in this city need? Do we have the courage to do a 5-4 vote today and call Jenny Durkin's bluff? If you want to veto it, you have to veto it in the broad light of day. Be accountable and transparent to the people, and then make sure that working people understand that Jenny Durkin is not your friend. Just this year, we're only in the month of May, and already 42 people have died on the streets. So with a stroke of the pen, Mayor Durkin has written off the lives of our community members. We have to stand strong because we are fighting for the lives of our homeless community members, and we are fighting for the 23,000 households in our city that are paying more than half of their income in rent. It is time to fight for housing justice, stand up to Bezos's bullying, fight Jenny Durkin's and Bezos's deal.
If you don't compromise, you may get nothing. Or would there be any compromise you'd be willing to make here? If you can't get the $75 million passed, it might be zero. Are you willing to move?
I am absolutely confident that the movement has built to such a degree. We are seeing so much momentum with the majority of people in this city saying that they want a real solution to housing. We saw the study from the Chamber of Commerce yesterday, which said that we need affordable housing units. Well, that's what we're talking about. And I'm confident that we are going to win. It's a question of what we win and how much we win. And it is actually really important for the movement to stand strong right now. It is not a done deal. It is not a done deal. We have today committee and we have full council on Monday. We have to keep fighting.
So just to be clear, if you have a 5-4 vote and Mayor Durkin vetoes it, your position?
If we have a 5-4 vote and Mayor on the $75 million proposal, and if Mayor Durkin has the courage to veto it, then we will keep building the movement. I have no doubt that the movement will be absolutely energized to make sure that we call Jenny Durkin's bluff. But the point to understand here is that what the establishment wants is for the city council to cave and for Jenny Durkin to not be challenged. What I'm saying is that let's call Jenny Durkin's bluff. Let's have a 5-4 vote in favor of $75 million, no sunset clause, and let's put it to the mayor. The mayor is supposed to be leading the city. Let's see what leadership we get. Do we get a leadership that stands with the struggling tens of thousands of working people, or do we get a corporate sweetheart deal for Amazon?
There are a number of people, I want to end with this, in the business community. You saw a letter earlier this week, more than 100 businesses teaming together for a letter that said that this is a misguided approach, that they are punishing businesses that hire a lot of people and have had great success in this city, providing great high-paying jobs for people in this city. To the people that say this is misguided, to say that it's way too extreme, what do you say to them?
Well, let's keep in mind that it is not a few people on the fringe who are demanding that we tax big business in order to fund social housing that is permanently affordable, publicly owned housing. We are talking about the whole gamut of our city, our childcare providers, our educators, our public school cafeteria workers, our bus drivers, our security personnel, our parking lot attendants, all of these people who, without whom this city would come to a standstill in a single day. These are the backbone of our society, and the backbone of our society is demanding that the city's political leadership do something about this and build affordable housing. So the real question is, who is being let down here? It's the working people who are being let down. And let's remember that many of the businesses who are saying that this is not going to work, this is a bad idea, they were the same businesses who 4 years ago said $15 an hour is not going to work, it's going to be economic apocalypse. And what happened? Seattle kept booming. And in reality,
Provide a lot of jobs as well for the working people, like the Carpenters Union that was
here.
We
are talking about actual economic evidence that shows that taxing big business has no negative impact on the economy. But you're bringing up a very important question. The question is, does Amazon and do the big businesses, we are talking about the 3% of the largest businesses.
We're talking about nearly 600 companies here in Seattle.
These are the top businesses in our city. You know, 600 is a misleading number. You have to think about the fact that they are the 3% of the top businesses. These are businesses that make the maximum amount of revenues. These are not your struggling immigrant-owned coffee shop in your neighborhood. So let's be very clear. Let's not have misleading rhetoric tell us that this is a bad deal. And let's keep in mind that the economics shows that actually taxing big business causes no negative impacts. But I think it's an important question that you're bringing up, because the fact is, businesses like Amazon and businesses in that 3% category do not need to take away jobs, but they will threaten us with the jobs. That's what Boeing has done decade after decade. That is why we need an alternative to this capitalist race to the bottom. And the way you reverse, the way you flip that race to the bottom over its head is for us to fight for housing justice, not just in Seattle, but in every city in America, because Amazon's threat was not just against Seattle, it was issued to every city in America.
Councilmember Shama Sawant, thank you for your time. Obviously going to be a very interesting day at City Hall. As you can hear from her disappointment and frustration with Amazon. Amazon, again, a company that provides 45,000 jobs in this city. The head tax, the debate continues. Which way will the council go? We'll see later today. Mimi and Jake.